with Sorrel from Armenian Cuisine, of course, because I doubt that many will make soup with Sorrel. And Sorrel in Armenian is called aveluk. And I want you to see how it looks when it's dry. Usually in Armenia, we gather this herb or green in summertime, and then I want you to see how it's nicely braided. And then we braid it and let out to dry in the sun for a month. So that's why when we about to cook something with aveluk or with sorrel, it's important that you wash it thoroughly. And because you can't just get and wash the dry herb or green, you would dip it in hot water. So what you do, I did this earlier, so we don't have to wait, because it takes time for the sorrel to soften and to get ready for cooking. So twice, you would pour some hot water twice. So this is the second water, and you would let it sit about 30 minutes for the first time, and then another 20 minutes for the second time. And then you will discard that water, which I'm going to do. And this is probably one of the most healthiest herbs on planet Earth. Okay, let me just squeeze this, just like this. And this is sold in most Armenian stores. I haven't checked other supermarkets, because I always can find this from Armenian store. But I'm sure you should be able to find this online. So this is how it looks when it's all soft and clean. And what you do with your sorrel, 1 minute, I need to open some space. And additionally, we also need onion, garlic, walnuts is a must as an ingredient. And I am going to show you the most simplest way of making this soup, my grandma's way. And then during some time, I will also show you other recipes with aveluk. You can also make salads with aveluk, so delicious and so healthy, as I already said. Also, we need water, of course, and then flour to make the soup thicker. And this is also called pshedur by my grandma's version. And pshedur is something that she'd add flour in the soup to make it thick and thick. Of course, salt, and I'm using olive oil. She would use clarified butter. I think that's it. Yeah, and red pepper, black pepper to taste. So let me show you how we do this. First, as I mentioned, you need to wet the aveluk twice in hot water, discard the hot water, chop it, put in a pot, cold water, and start boiling. So I'll go ahead, quickly chop aveluk or sorrel, and then we'll go from there. I'm done chopping my sorrel. And when you come up with really tough ones, just remove them. This means they have dried that aveluk when it was already not very tender, and they do that sometimes. Okay, so what we just need to cook this until it's tender. And you would figure out if it's tender, you'll grab one of those stems and just try it with your fingers, just see if it rips apart. This tastes good already. It means it's cooked. Okay, so I'll add some cold water, start cooking, and I'll show you what we do the rest after. While that's cooking, we can go ahead and start sauteing onions, a little bit of olive oil. See, this is, again, I keep making and saying that there are things you don't need a recipe. You just do it by hand by eyeballing and with lots of love, and it will turn out the best, the most delicious. You don't have to look at numbers to make a delicious food, okay? All right, so I'll put this to saute until translucent. And then I'll add some flour. If you remember, if you watched my other Peshajur video tutorial, again by my grandmother's recipe, it was called Lobov Peshajur, very similar to this one with aveluk. She'd make saute onions and then add some flour, a little bit of stock from that boiling aveluk or beans, make it into thick custard and then add it to the soup, and that's it. Oh, I need to bring some tomato paste, and because I don't have tomato paste, I may bring red pepper paste, just as an option, replacement for tomato paste. Okay, so I'll let this saute and we'll be done with our soup within very short time. My aveluk has been cooking almost 15 minutes and onions are sauteed ready. I chopped my walnut, so we're ready to go and we're gonna finish the soup within 5-7 minutes. And I cooked a lot because I want to show you a salad with aveluk. It's so delicious. Again, very healthy, delicious Armenian salad. So I'll set some aside, and from one pot of aveluk you should be able to make 4 soups with this recipe. And I'll set some aside and I'll put the link for myfruitlavash.com. You can buy aveluk from that store. Okay, so I'll set this aside and it's cooked perfectly. It's tender. Okay, so we'll save this for our salad, and the rest I'm gonna cook it here so you can see. Okay, I'll set this here for now. And to our onions, I'm going to add about a tablespoon of flour and start cooking again. A few minutes. Just a little bit of that aveluk stuck in. Just a tiny bit. I'll add more later. So I'll set this here. Okay. A few minutes and then I'll add my pepper paste. I have a tutorial for this red pepper paste if you wanna try making it. Or use tomato sauce, probably 2 tablespoons of sauce and 2 teaspoons of tomato paste. Okay, I'll add just a little bit of more stock. I'll switch to wooden spoon, not to torture your ears. As it starts to sizzle, go ahead and add a little bit more stock. You want to have this thick, custardy mixture. Just add and stir. I'll add a little bit more, just like this. And then I'll go ahead and add my red pepper paste. A little bit more because I like it spicy. I'll cook this another minute or 2 and then I'll place my pot on the stove, like change the places. Add my salt and then black pepper, red pepper. If you're not adding red pepper paste, I would suggest to use the pepper because I already added enough peppers. I'll skip the jalapeno peppers. Okay, so this is ready. I'll put this here, just like this. And then add this about 2-3 tablespoons at a time and stir. You don't want to have any lumps in this soup. And this is such a thick and rich soup. There are other variations with bulgur and then lentils, potatoes, dried plums, sour plums. So many variations of the same soup, because usually and normally different Armenian regions would make the same dish differently. So this was my, and originally my grandma from father's side is from Lori, Tavush region in Armenia. So this is how they would make it. I'll let this boil 2-3 minutes. You know what? I'll add the salt now. Salt, pepper, salt to taste, pepper also to taste. If you like it thicker, go ahead, add a little bit bulgur. That's another recipe, but you can always go with your own version just to make it thicker and with less nutrients and vitamins. Yeah, if you have time, go ahead and Google the nutrition facts for sorrel. It's so rich with all kinds of different vitamins. Okay, so I'll let this cook a few more minutes, add my walnuts, and we're done. That's it. I'll taste the salt. More salt. As the soup starts to boil, go ahead and add walnuts. A handful of walnuts, I'd say. And let it cook another minute or two. And while it's cooking, quickly grate the garlic. And usually we serve this with garlic and vinegar. Garlic and vinegar. So simple. Not too many ingredients. And so delicious. You'll be amazed how a simple herb can make such a delicious and healthy meal. And unfortunately, as always, my children will not join me for this soup. So that was about my pain. Okay, and I love this with old bread. Usually we'd put the bread chunks, old bread chunks into soup and eat it. And it was the best, the most delicious thing ever. Okay, you know what? My soup is ready, okay? I don't have the patience. It boiled. It looks so good. It smells amazing. So this is it for our sorrel soup or avelukov pshedjur from Armenian cuisine. Hope you guys try it, like it, and yeah, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like the video, and I can't wait to try this. Just a little bit of garlic. I'll use this spoon. Smells so, so delicious. And rye bread is the best with this soup. That's it. Thank you everyone for watching. Remember to subscribe to my channel. It's so hot. Okay. So delicious. So, so good. I can't wait. I'll turn this off. Go sit down and enjoy my meal properly. And you go ahead, make the soup. Let me know how you liked it. Stay tuned for Aveluk salad. For salad. Aveluk salad. Sometimes I just speak Armenian. Armenian but with English. Mixed with English. Okay guys, thank you everyone for watching. I'll see you soon. So delicious.